Hi, welcome back to my channel, Ashra's Edumandri Lake, Everkun Swagadam. In the tutorial video, my channel Yamanitula, only first year students in Anuja Maitula, Uru study video sana, upon the Mukakana. Hi guys, what's up? This is Ashra Sivanesh. Hope you are well. Today we are discussing about the topic carpentry for poly first year students. We already studied some of the carpentry tools like marking and measuring tools. So we can continue. Then cutting tools. Cutting tools include saws, chisels and gauges. Let us start with saw. So a saw is generally specified by the length of its blade measured along the tooth edge and pitch of a tip expressed in millimeters. Okay, then we have some of important saws: rip saw, cross cut saw, compass saw, tenon or back saw, etc. So let us start with rip saw. Rip saw are used for cutting along the grain in thick wood. You should remember for cutting along the grain. Okay, the blade is made of a high grade tool steel and may be either straight or skew back. It is fitted in a wooden handle made of a hardwood by means of rivets or screws. And rip saws are about 700 mm long with 3 to 5 points or teeth per 25 mm. So again we have cross cut saw. Cross cut saw also is known as a hand saw, and it is used for cutting across the grain. For rip saw, for along the grain, but here cross cut saw, it is used for cutting across the grain. Got it? In thick wood. Then they are 600 to 650 mm long with 8 to 10 teeth per 25 mm. Here the figure for rip saw and cross cut hand saw. Here the rip saw is used for cutting along the grains, but here cross cut hand saw, it is used for cutting across the grain. Okay, and here we have again tenon or back saw. This saw is mostly used for cross cutting when a finer and more accurate finish is required. You should remember, when a finer and more accurate finish is required, which saw is used? The tenon or back saw is used. Got it? And the blade, being very thin, is reinforced with a rigid steel back. And tenon saw blades are vary from 250 to 400 mm in length with 13 teeth per 25 mm. And you should remember one term, peg teeth. What is that? Peg teeth. The teeth are shaped in the form of an equilateral triangle. What is that? Equilateral triangle, and are sometimes termed peg teeth. So peg teeth is related to what is that? Tenon saw or back saw. Got it? Here the figure for tenon or back saw. It is used for finer cut. And again we have the other saw, compass saw. So for compass saw, it is used for sawing small curves in confined spaces and has a narrow tapering blade about 250 to 400 mm. So compass saw is used for sawing small curves in confined spaces. Okay, here the figure for compass saw. Then we have another cutting tool, chisel. Wood chisel most commonly in use include firmer chisel, either square of bevel edged chisel and motif chisels. They are usually specified by length and width of the blade. So chisels are usually specified by length and width of the blade. Okay, you should remember that the chisels are specified by length and width of the blade. Got it? So start with former chisel. The former chisel is the most useful for general purposes and may be used by hand pressure or mallet. It has a flat blade about 125 mm long, and the width of the blade varies from 1.5 to 50 mm. And again we have beveled edge former chisel. The beveled edge former chisel is used for more delicate or fine work. They are useful for getting into corners where the ordinary former chisel would be clumsy. So by comparing former chisel and beveled edge former chisel, the beveled edge former chisel is useful for getting into corners where the ordinary former chisel would be clumsy. So you should remember. Then again we have motive chisel. I already said what is the meaning of motis in previous class. Motis means simply holes, that is, hole means square or rectangle holes. So the motis chisel, as its name indicates, is used for chopping out mortises. These chisels are designed to withstand heavy work, and the motis chisel's blades vary in width from 3 to 16 mm. So we have the figure for former chisel, bevel edge former chisel and motis chisel. Next we have planing tools. For that planes, the plane can be likened to the chisel fastened into a block of metal or wood, and its blade cut exactly like a wide chisel. So in the plane, the blade acting like a wide chisel. So we have a lot of planes. There is a jack plane and a metal jack plane. This is the parts for jack plane. This is the blade, verge, back iron, and here we have metal jack plane. There is a lot of parts for this. This is the handle, cutting iron, cap iron, lever cap, knob, etc. So we can see detail. For jack plane, it is the common and is used for the first truing up of a piece of wood for smoothening the surface of the wood. Jack plane is used for what purposes? It is used for smoothening the surface of a wood piece. So it consists of a block of wood into which a blade is fixed by a wooden verge. The blade is set at an angle of 45 degree to the saw. So you should remember, for the metal jack plane or jack plane, we can have set an angle of 45 degree to the sword for what blade. On the cutting blade, another blade is fixed called a cap iron or back iron. This does not cut. You should remember the back iron, this does not cut, but stiffen the blade near its cutting edge to prevent for what chattering, and partially breaks the shaving as it's made. And it is the back iron which causes the shavings to be curled when they come out of the plane. And we have the blade which is obtainable from 350 to 425 mm in length, and its blade width are 50 to 75 mm. And here we have the pictures. And this is the jack plane. Here the wooden body. Here the metal jack plane. This is the metal body. Metal planes serve the same purposes as the wooden plane, but it facilitates a smoother operation and better finish. but it provides smoother operation and better finish for metal jack plane. The body of a metal plane is made from a gray iron casting with the side and sword machined and ground to a bright finish. The thickness of the shaving remote is governed by a fine screw adjustment and a lever is used for adjusting the blade at right angles. Here the figure for metal jack plane. This is the adjusting screw. By adjusting this screw, we can increase the depth of the blade based upon our need. Then we have completed some of carpentry tools like marking and measuring tools, cutting tools and planing tools. So we have remaining lot of tools. The next part will come soon. Thank you.